I keep hearing people say all the time, did you vote in the last election?
It's too much money here. I mean, nobody should be hitting lotto for $36 million if you got people starving in the streets. That is not idealistic. That is stupid. There's no way. There's no way that these people should own planes and their people don't have houses, apartments, shacks. It just don't make sense to me. I think that when there's hopelessness, people vote. We got to survive here.
I keep hearing people say all the time, did you vote in the last election?
No.
Well then, you don't have any say in the matter. You gave up your right to have a say.
You see, that's a democracy speaking. The truth is, in a constitutional republic, whether you vote or not, the law protects you equally like it protects everybody else. And voting cannot change the law. You have a right to vote, but you are not mandated to vote. You don't have to vote if you don't want to. And not voting is a way of protesting. And if you'll look at how many people in this country have stopped voting, it's got to be the biggest protest in the history of the nation. People are saying, we don't believe in the system anymore. We don't believe you're going to represent us. We don't believe our vote counts. We believe it's a waste of time, and so we're not going to do it. We believe that the outcome is going to be the same whether we go and vote or whether we stay home and don't vote. And you know, folks, they're absolutely right when they think that. They're absolutely right when they think that. Absolutely correct. They're absolutely right. Absolutely correct. Only difference between Gore and G.W. Bush is Gore would have taken us there a lot faster, and Bush is going to slow us down so his buddies in the oil business can make tons of money before world socialism takes over. And if you don't believe it, you think I'm full of it. You know, I've never been wrong about this stuff yet. If you think I'm full of it, just stick around, you know, watch what happens. Hearing people say all the time, did you vote in the last election? No. No.
This is a big question. No one's been able to answer it. This is staggering. How can Reagan live in a White House which has a lot of rooms and there'd be homelessness? And he's talking about helping homelessness. This is what I mean about practicality. Either there's someone homeless in Washington, D.C., if there's homelessness and he has the White House which has 1,000 rooms, why can't he take some of them people off the street and put them in his White House? Because he doesn't want to get dirty. The White House would be a little tainted.
You have a right to vote. But you are not mandated to vote. You don't have to vote if you don't want to. You have a right to vote. But you are not mandated to vote. Outcome is going to be the same whether we go and vote or whether we stay home and don't vote.